Hey, welcome to this video. Today we're diving into an exciting topic, creating a cyclic load simulation in Abaqus via a hysteresis loop. We'll explore how materials behave under repeated loading and unloading and how to capture those all important force versus displacement curves. So let's get started. As usual, we start with part. So create part, extrusion 200. And we create a rectangle. The length should be 100, the width should be 10, and the depth also has to be 10. Okay, this is the part we are going to work with, which is a cantilever beam. Now it's time to create the property. So create the material. We can name it steel. General density 7.8E-9, and from mechanical elasticity elastic 210,000, and here must be 0.33, and from the mechanical plasticity plastic I have this Excel file, so we can control C and control V here to copy and paste the material properties, and this is done. Now we're going to create a section. Section 1, solid homogeneous, assigned to the material steel, and now we want to assign the section to the material. Uncheck this one in order not to create too many sets, and we're done here. Okay, it's time to go to the assembly. Now we assemble a part independent, and it's better to translate this instance. So here, done, I select this part, middle of the cantilever beam, and put it here and click OK. Now we have our part here assembled. Now it's time to go to the step. From the step, we create a static general step. The NLGM must be turned on because there's a large displacement. This must be 0.1. 1E-9 is okay. Then okay. Now another thing we can do is to create a reference point. So from here, tools, reference point, we must create it here. So it's 100, and in the y direction it's 5, then this is 0. Now we created the reference point here. Now we're good to go to the interaction. We want to couple this surface to this reference point. So we want to create a coupling constraint here. Constraint, coupling, continue. Now we selected the reference point, and then it's time to select the node region, and done. We accept everything, and okay, as you see here, this yellow line indicates that the interaction is applied. Now we are done in the interaction, and it's time to go to the load. Here, create boundary condition. I would select the first one first, and it's better to rotate the part to here. We can hit the escape button, select this one, done, and it should be in cast, done. Now we jump back to this part. We create another boundary condition of the displacement and rotation. We click continue. We can select the RP point because it has everything that this surface has. So everything must be 0, but this one must be 1 millimeter. Now here is the most important part, is to create the amplitude. So here we should click on this one to create the amplitude. We can name it cyclic load. Okay, continue. Now we copy and paste the amplitude here. So this creates a hysteresis loop. When the time is zero, the amplitude is zero, and when it's 0.1, it's 1 millimeter, and when it's 0.3, it's 2 millimeter, and so on. Now before we hit the OK, we have to select the cyclic load in order to be activated. Then OK. Now we're done with this load and boundary condition, and we can go to the mesh. We can use the value of 2. Now this is okay, and it's time to go to submit the job. So we create a job, we call that cyclic load, continue, okay. We submit the job. Now the job is completed. Let's go and see the results. Okay, if I put it on this one to see the contour, and let's slow down the animation a little bit, and we see that this is going up and down in the amplitude we program for it. Okay, now I would like to go to the very last step, and now it's time to go to create XY data, ODB field output, continue, and here we should use the unique nodal and RF2 U2, and from here we should go to the node sets, and we use this reference point and plot. As you see, the displacement and force versus time going in this sinusoidal way. So we want to go for force versus displacement. From here, operate on XY data, continue, and from combine, we double click U2 and RF2, and now we plot the expression. If we zoom out a little, we see the whole hysteresis loop. It starts from here, it goes to 1, then to minus 1, then goes to 2, minus 2, and creates the whole hysteresis loop. And that's it. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe and check out the next video right here before it ends. See you in the next one.